How's it going, everybody? My name is Sky. Welcome to Monster Hunter Rise. It's awesome to have you here. It's cold and rainy. I have some coffee and I think it's the perfect day for some bullshit. I don't know why I decided to do this, but I just decided, you know, let's try it out. We've only fought her once before. But based on that one time, there's a lot that we can kind of infer about how this is gonna go. In terms of this, let's go, I don't know. She doesn't have too many fireballs though. I wonder if Moxie is the best way. Let's do that. Yeah, so there's a few things about her moveset based on that one experience that we've had with her. I think we can get a few things from that. So she kind of moves back a little bit when she does her dangerous tail attack, almost as if she's stunned. So your brain automatically thinks, you know, okay, she's stunned. It's a small opening or something, but it's not. The second thing that's really dangerous is that she can do two of those diagonal tail attacks, and you might think it's an opening, but she can immediately follow it up with a regular vertical one. Find that very interesting, and yes, we got all of it. I should have used a ticket, but I mean, we managed to get everything anyway. I do want to change this out as well, because I like charging the sword. It allows us to be a lot more defensive, staying in sword and shield mode, and being able to still get a lot of damage in. But it's been a while since we've actually used our spinning slash, and I feel like we've fallen into a very defensive, very like turtle like kind of playstyle that I didn't have before. I think that Rajang battle is what got me to play a lot more defensively. But either way, this is where we're at. I'm gonna run around and get some of these, because I'm not gonna go in with a potential one shot looming over. I know there's a toad or something around here. Puppet spider. So that's potentially a woven ride that we can get just for free. No! What is use the foul vine? I still haven't figured that out. Seems to be just nothing that way. Is there really only two more? Ah, the rest are underground. Okay. Get away from me. Let me just see if there's anything, you know, close by. I don't think we've ever figured that out. Like, how do we get there? Because it's on this level of the map, it's not above or below or anything. Wow. It's just a bowl of Oh no, hard armor sphere. The armor spheres are good. Should probably knock those over whenever we get the chance. We don't have any charge blade that's particularly good against Rathian, so we're just going with the Mizutsune one because we haven't used it yet. I think it might be fun, and she's equally, I believe, she's equally weak to water and ice. Yeah. So something is better than nothing. Because I don't want to use poison. And I think we've been using our... I love that Camellia's charge blade. We've been using it a lot, so... good to do something different. I think we're good. Like, one more and we're at max health. Can you... Alright. Actually, this way is better. Okay, so I have my herbal medicine, that's good. Should have taken these while we're still up on top. But that's fine. Gonna follow it up with another. No. Shit. Should not counter that. Countering that is stupid. Oh, she's leaving already. Yeah, so countering that is really stupid because you just open for the next one. I wonder, because you can counter and go straight into charge shield mode. I wonder if you can make it in time to get the guard point from it. Right. Okay, so that's the armor bar at the top. Cool. I'm so happy I now know what those do, because I just haven't been picking them up because I thought I just couldn't figure it out. There we go, max health. There we go. Enraged. Oh! Super Saiyan is here. Good. Can you not do that? I'm so happy he's here. This is gonna help a lot. What? Like, what the fuck? Honestly? Rajang is absolutely insane. Come on, one more. Shit. I was getting a bit too. But I'm still really happy with that. Again with the screaming, huh? Shit. Didn't want to risk trying to do a follow-up because she normally does another attack after. Clip the tail, that's good.
Hi.
Shot one.
Got it, Ida.
Oh damn, you can break those. Okay. That adds a bit more to this. I'm still trying to wonder what the comments from the initial fight were about because that video isn't even live yet, and I'm trying to do this. I should have just waited. I probably would have gotten like crazy amount of information. But you know, I'm impatient. I don't know what got into me today. But yeah, there we are. Damn it! She pushed me into it. I knew I shouldn't have trusted it. So that's the regular poison, I'm sure. Start coming. So it's not necessarily that it's almost like she's stunned. It's more like she looks like she's about to charge. Damn, that was just I got a bit disorientated there at the end. I deserve that. I know where I messed up. Let me do this while I have the idea, because I just thought of this. Cook that. So let's leave four there, back at the... So that way when it's used, it just disappears. Right? And then I can save that. So everything is the same, but... then I don't have to cycle so much.
Hi.
I could probably refine that idea, but at least having it there means that I'll think about it again when I see it. And at that point I can probably do more with it. Don't really use a lot of the other stuff, like dash juice and stuff. Maybe I should. I just never have the need. I guess it would be useful, because we do have yeah, straight out the gate with that, huh? Hitting the wing. I don't know why I didn't. I must press there. Not the best place to fight her. Chill out over here. Yep. You're gonna follow it up with another. Yep. Wait, what? Oh, summoner cat. Damn. Did not expect that. I was so focused on the Raffi, and I didn't even realize. There we go. Yeah, you see, it almost seems like she's either stunned or about to charge or something. Just want to sharpen a little bit. She's gone.
Hi.
Ooh. Ow. Come on. Fuck, no. So you can't. You can't get the guard point. Maybe you can, and I'm need to time it better, but it seemed like it was too quick. See, I still am getting tricked by it, because it seems like it's the exact thing that a monster usually does when they take damage and they take a step back. How did that hit me? Oh right, now you do the second one. Shit. I was supposed to. Thinking that it's gonna hit me, but doesn't matter. Again, how many times am I gonna get fooled by it? What are you doing? I messed it up there at the end. pretend you didn't see that. That's the most embarrassing thing ever. I keep on getting fooled by it because, as I said, it's the exact... I think that they actually did that intentionally. They made it look like she does the animation of, you hit me a lot, I'm gonna take a step back and scream a little bit, which is a small opening, but instead she takes a step back and absolutely destroys me. Still got poisoned though. Facing the wrong way. See, like something like that. She almost makes it look like it was something like that, but it's actually not. I got tricked again. Every time I see that, my brain is like opening. Bamboozled. You two are doing really good, by the way. That's right. I still needed this because I fainted. I took it out at the exact moment that I put them away, but I didn't end up using it. You are like right here. And real life Sphinx is crying from outside of the door because he wants to get in. But I know that once he's in, can't reach that tail. Oh, man. Dead. Would be nice if Sphinx would heal me. Oh, he's doing the tree. Oh! Good boy. Very good job. He's just standing there. He's just standing there like, I made this tree, my job is done. What else is there to live for? I messed up badly. I don't think that this is a good place to be. I only have one more mega potion? How did that happen? I'm just trying to spot where the lucky lad is so that I know. I don't think I'm ever gonna I don't think I'm ever going to get over the fact that my brain... It's like they took the exact habit that they know you have after fighting so many monsters. Oh, that's regular poison. Okay. Let's get back on track here because I've been like missing hits and stuff. She's doing that a lot all of a sudden. No, you little shit. I didn't mean to do that. I don't know. How? It's like every single attack is that one attack, and I'm still getting hit by it. She's not doing any other attacks. Okay, that was a little bit of a disaster. Where did that lucky life go? Oh man, it went all the way there. It is worth it to still get it though. I think if I go to this camp, I can go straight down to that spot. Damn, I was so into the fight, I didn't drink my coffee. Where was the way down? Right here. What is this? A lot of these other materials, as I was saying in the other video, they mostly took a backseat. At this point. Now the game is all about like water orbs and wind serpent orbs and stuff. Get a stamina back up. I wonder if she's sleeping up there. She might be. She didn't sleep the last time that we fought her, when she got low. But I think that might have been because we were too close. Nah, she's just not sleeping. I mean, that was stupid, I was looking the other way. Huh? Some of it I just don't understand. Don't do that. You're on fire. You need to roll normally. Nah. No. Oh shit. I'm surprised. One of the things I'm surprised about is like the mega potions. I brought like the honey and the regular potions, so shouldn't it have combined by now? Don't they combine as you use them? That's how it's worked before. See, there's like a lot of shit to get through, and this radio menu, I don't like using the diagonals because the diagonals are very inconsistent. Dude, how do I get down there? Like, not there. This map is so confusing. Where's the hole? Is this a hole? This last bird is really dragging out because I just didn't know where she went. I had to try because I messed up by using the counter because I thought it was going to be a charge once again. Luckily she did that because I was wondering where to go. Like, I don't want to just run in because she does that once I do. How did that hit me? I feel like I was out of range. Dude, no. Dude, use the fucking thing, damn. If I died there, this is one of the reasons why I was dreading the emergencies, is because the game just decides sometimes, no, you're not gonna use items. You hit the button, but no items for you. And if I ever died to something like that, after like 40 minutes of fighting, like, if I fight one of these emergencies for like 40 minutes, trying and trying and trying my best, and then I die to something like that, ooh, I would have been pissed. Well, what a fun fight. Just, I really do think that they were intentional with the psychology behind that attack. I do think, I might be just speaking complete nonsense here, but I do think that that was what they tried to do. They tried to trick you into thinking that it was an opening. So all of the muscle memory that you have up until this point is exactly what your brain just automatically says, okay, opening, attack. And then you get hit by her most dangerous attack. But yeah. I've seen in the comments here and there, people have said that they've been hunting these things in like 5 minutes and 8 minutes and 10 minutes. This was like back, way back. Not emergency monsters, but like monsters in general. And that is kind of insane. Like, I took 37 minutes here. Granted, I was running around and doing some weird shit, but still. Rathi and Ruby, awesome. So the Felicrow got us some Lazarite jewels. Nice. That was really fun. I'm surprised. Based on that, I honestly think that my run-in with Apex Azeroth is not a good indicator of the emergencies. I think that Azeroth is just a very difficult one for me. Or maybe she's the easiest, I don't know. I could be wrong about everything that I'm saying. What I wanted to do was that quest that unlocks that layered set. I want to do another one because I want a few other pieces. But I can't remember which one it was. It wasn't that. I wonder if I'll be able to. I feel like I might be able to handle that. Apex Diablos though, my god. There was one that we did that had some really good materials to craft gear that gleams like an Azure star. Let me just read that thing. It's a good time to practice against Macamalo as well, if it is this one. Azure Age, yeah, it should be this one, yeah. I need to do that one, and I need to do the one. The other one I want was this one. So I need the ones for the Celestial Scroll as well. Yeah, going back to the spinning slash, I think is really good because that's what I've been used to for most of my time with the charge blade, and then I've been trying out if we don't get a faint, Moneymaker might be nice, but I am worried about Almatron and Magnamalo. They're both very difficult for me. Let's go Slugger. Yeah, while I like the charged sword, switch scale, it's really awesome, and it gives you a lot of variety, but I like the spinning sword slash. Spinning slash, whatever it's called. I just realized maybe I said the wrong word there. And let's go. I should use more tickets. But this isn't one of those crazy events. But I need to keep in mind for the emergencies, like use tickets.
Hi.
Actually, let's go for Magnum Mello first, because we didn't change our charge blade, and I think he's weak to water. Yep. And then, who else is here? Almadron. You can use fire there, and I'm sure Tetranodon fire as well. Yeah. Always good to have beetles.
Hide.
After that apex fight, I know it's not the most difficult one. I'm feeling really confident. So maybe we'll try that with the Rathalos. Might be a bad idea, might be a good one. That's unfair. How is that fair? Oh, I thought it was gonna be the tackle. That damn attack. He's leaving, buddy. Oh shit, this thing is gonna go off. Look, I know that Rathalos and Rathian are two completely different beasts. But let's, I think maybe we'll try it in the next one. Might be fun. And for now, I want to skip Apex Azeroth's emergency. Because, I don't know, it's just something about that fight. Like, the Rathian one was so much easier. So Thunderblight makes them more susceptible to stun, right? Shit. Oh. I was safe the entire time. That I hit the counter. Shit. I'm like back into a corner here.
Get away from me!
What? No, shit, is he gonna kill me? Normally when he does that, he comes back down with a follow-up. Like, he goes up and then he hits his tail down. So I wonder why he didn't do it there. Oh shit. I'm trying my stupid moves that I shouldn't be trying. There's no way. I should have known it was there, even though I didn't see it because it was clipped through the wall. Like, can you give me a chance, please? Yeah, please go away. This guy's a lot, man. He's a lot to deal with. Why can't I? But... Oh, he has. he had Hellfire back. The wall running, man. I wonder how difficult it must be to create good wall running if that's what they settled with. Okay, I call bullshit on that, by the way. You even saw the animation miss me, and then I teleported into his attack. That is bullshit. I miss this so much. Shit! Why did I dodge backwards? What? It even made the sound that I counted. Yeah, I'm probably dead. I did kind of go into that one, so. Am I gonna make it? Yes. I don't think I've ever seen him do that before. Damn it! I tried to hit the counter, I was way too late on it. That attack is a lot quicker than I give it credit for. He comes up really fast. The charge, the first part of the attack, the charge part. So you, I think it's better to, I don't even think a counter would have been good though. Like what would I do after, because there is that follow-up part. But I guess if I charge the shield after the counter, it's not the most difficult thing to dodge, but when you're in axe mode, certain things are a bit too wide to effectively dodge without like really good position. And I don't think I have really good dodges and positioning. This guy's like gonna get deep fired. He's dead, but it's so fun to just grind away at their head. what I say. Just on the apex right at the end, emergency. That's why it's always good to chill out and hunt monsters on a rainy day. Because it's the rainy days, it's something about like the tranquility. You have like this inner peace. Really helpful. I mean, nothing can get you down, you know, when you have that inner peace. They can try all they want. I need to switch the charge blade. Interesting, you can't do layered armor from there. It's fine, but it just doesn't match. Oh, he's going there, so this is perfect. You can... Oh my god, the fish. I thought that was an attack, but it wasn't. Okay, you are doing like some weird shit. I'll just get that charge. How? I'm so mad about that. just like the worst possible luck ever. What are you doing? Can you stop that? Dumbass. Oh, he's doing his thing, yeah. Okay. What the hell is that? Get out. Can you move your arm, dude? Just has his arm in the way the entire time. I do have to hunt both of these guys, so... Big jumps. Let's go. Damn it. What? This is why this guy, man. He's a lot. Wow, look at my stamina. Oh, dang. More plates. We're getting really lucky with the plates and stuff. Which is nice. I'm gonna beat you there. Probably not. Down you go. Aye. Larger size. Incredible. Okay, so I got hit a lot there. And yeah, his fight is still like a really weird one. But this switch skill setup actually works a lot better. Because I was trying to think at one point, but the first time that we fought him, and also when we fought him in the hub, in the high rank hub, he was fine. He was fine in the high rank hub. No, was he? I think that's maybe the one that we soloed and we got a bit irritated with. But he was fine the first time, and we used this setup, or we used some other setup. I don't know what we were using. But like, why was there such a disparity? Given that period. How is drinking water? I keep on forgetting that he has a scream after he gets his belly. Why did I turn? Oh, it's a double hit, so I shouldn't counter. Ow. Oh, he was going over there. Interesting. Please don't lock me in this corner. Can I get out? There's so much of space here. Why do you want to fight there? No fucking way. Damn. I mean, there's nothing that you can do but respect him for that. Sorry. God, this is such a fun weapon. Damn it. When I want you to hit me, you don't. Alright, I can go into the spinning slash from the counter. I forgot about that. I haven't used it in so long. Should probably heal now. No way! I thought I blocked that. I mean, you get clapped, you get clapped. What are you gonna do? Didn't mean to use a potion. I'm supposed to just sharpen. But anyway. Something interesting is I feel like we are running out of potions faster than we are able to make them. It's something I never thought would happen. But that's the situation. Like, the Argosy is strictly now for potion stuff and honey and all of that. What? I know it can be countered. It's been done before. Oh, he's dead. Wow. I don't even realize he was low. I am really, really, really enjoying the recent hunts that we've been having. The Apex Rathian emergency, this one, even the previous episode, the Apex Mizutsune. What else did we do? It was, I think it was a Rakna, Kadaki, and a Rathalos. It was awesome. Like, I was a bit rusty when I started playing again, like 2 days ago or something. In terms of episodes, 2 days ago would have been the episode that was the layered set, I believe. But I was a bit rusty in that one, but I think we got it back really quickly. Is this what we needed? Doesn't seem like it. We're at 95. Yeah, because I was going to do the Apex Rathalos and then do another episode where we just do some like miscellaneous hunts and stuff, but you know, I just woke up this morning with a vengeance, it seems. There it is. So we can make two more items. I like the arms. Chest and the coil. The coil is really, really good. Thing about the arms is that it kind of like starts halfway, so I think like when we're building a set and we need something like similar to this, then we'll see if one of them fit. I like to keep it in because I don't want to use it and then realize I want another piece or something. Yeah, but either way, thanks so much for stopping by. This was awesome. I enjoyed this a lot. All such fun and enjoyable hunts that we went on, so yeah. I was dreading the emergencies for so long. I think while I had it on my mind now that I felt like I wanted to do it, then I think that it was like a really good idea to just go ahead and tackle it, because I think that was what was able to now clear my head for the future. So maybe we'll try Apex Rathalos emergency in the next one. Oh, we might just go for the regular one. I'll see how I'm feeling. I don't want to be too strict on it and just do it for the sake of doing it. I want to do it like what it was like today, where I felt like I wanted to. So, hope that makes sense. I don't know if I worded that very well, but either way, subscribe if you're new, and I'll see you in the next one for Apex Rathalos, where there's the emergency or the regular one. But bye for now.